Minnesota is making progress. That's according to a new state auditor's report about a controversial law.
It allows police to take and keep your property even if you're never charged with a crime. For years, investigative reporter Eric Rasmussen has been revealing the real life impacts of forfeiture, and he joins us now with this new information. Eric.
Lindsay, Kevin, that new report shows the amount and value of property taken through forfeiture is down in Minnesota. And when she sat down with us today, Auditor Julie Blaha told me new legislation is just part of what's driving the kind of change advocates have been demanding. Cars and cash seized by police. When they said we're taking it, did you understand what that meant?
I thought they were just taking it, like impounding it or something. Yeah, I didn't think like they were gonna keep it.
Over years of reporting, five investigates found the targets of forfeiture are often not criminal kingpins.
Makes no sense to me. But
and sometimes people never charged with a crime at all.
Here's the big trend. Asset forfeitures are down in Minnesota.
Now a new report from State Auditor Julie Blaha's office finds the value of cash and property seized by police dropped from nearly $11 million in 2021 to $9 million last year. The decline even larger over the last 5 years, with forfeitures down 35%.
Does this decline, does this trend happen without that intense scrutiny?
Well, of course, as a data person, I think without the data, it's hard to go anywhere. But I think what we're seeing is that when people come together and are working toward the same goal, they get results.
A new law passed in 2021 now bars police from seizing cash less than $1,500. And for the first time, law enforcement must report how they spent money from forfeiture. Out of $8.5 million statewide in 2022, departments used about half of that for capital expenses on things like buildings and equipment and salaries.
This is not a large part of public safety budgets. You know, I think there's this myth that this is keeping places afloat. It's really not. And this is why I think it was easier to make some of these changes. When you have a tool that law enforcement can use, got to make sure the tool is doing what it's supposed to do. Forfeiture is supposed to take away the instruments of crime. Forfeiture is not supposed to assess a penalty before you've even had your day in court.
Among the things that haven't changed much in this year's report, cars, cash, and guns remain the top types of property seized by police through forfeiture. You can find more of our reporting on forfeiture on KSTP.com, and we'll continue to follow up. Live in the newsroom, Eric Rasmussen, 5 Eyewitness News.
All right, thanks for all your reporting on this, Eric.